Hi folks, I'm in Koramangala in Namma, Bengaluru, and I'm here for a meal at what is perhaps Bengaluru's most popular cafe. Get here on a weekend and your wait for a table could last up to an hour. Serving an all-day breakfast, Hole in the Wall literally began as a hole in the wall in a tiny garage in the back lanes of Koramangala in Bengaluru. Of course, today it's moved to a much larger setting in a bungalow that's been converted into a restaurant. But the feel is still cozy and homely and the perfect setting just for the kind of food that Hole in the Wall serves. So let's go in and check out what a meal at Hole in the Wall Cafe is all about. Let's go. Walking into Hole in the Wall Cafe is like walking into someone's living room. You look around and you find picture frames, you find all sort of curios and collectibles. It's the sort of stuff that you would probably collect from your travels over a period of years and hang it up on your wall. I think that is the appeal of the decor and of the space and the vibe here at Hole in the Wall Cafe. Hi Nathan, how are you?
Thanks, how are you?
So I'm here with Nathan, who along with his wife Lynn are the creators and the owners of Hole in the Wall Cafe. I think each time I come to Hole in the Wall Cafe, no matter what time of the day, it's always busy.
Yeah, well, we're on our way to finishing 10 years, almost 9.5.
Yeah.
We didn't envisage this sort of response to what we were going to do. Our idea was just to kind of start a very small little corner neighborhood sort of cafe.
That's what you started out as. Yeah,
but we were so wrong. I think after the first month, the whole thing just went crazy. The long lines of people waiting outside. We weren't prepared for it.
Okay, so who started? Whose idea was eggs?
So we love to eat out. We love to travel. We love to try different cuisines. We realized a lot of our conversations while we were dating and then we got married, all our conversations kind of revolved around food all the time. And then we would kind of just imagine all the time if we were to open our own place.
So when I look around and I see all these pictures on the wall, I see all these little trinkets, little curios that have probably been collected over a period of years. So was that the idea or is this something that just happened organically?
Well, I think it mostly happened organically, okay. But I think the objective was always trying to keep it as homely as possible.
Okay.
We didn't want it to look cosmetic. We didn't want to put in the latest things in the market that made it look as fancy and snappy.
So you didn't want that fancy, schmancy sort of a look. You wanted something which was real, which was just you and Lynn. And of course, it all began with Lynn in the kitchen, mostly, right?
Yeah, we started with a grand total of one person. We had a staff member. We did mostly cook food ourselves. Lynn was in the kitchen for the first year. And everything was guaranteed would have our fingerprints all over it if you ordered from the restaurant.
And of course, since then, the kitchen has evolved. Can we take a look at your kitchen?
Sure.
I can smell bacon and eggs. I think that's the one constant in this kitchen, right? I mean, given the number of eggs that you probably churn out every single day.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you ever counted how many eggs a day?
I know it runs into the thousands.
Into the thousands of
it
eggs.
It does, especially on the weekends.
So I can see some bacon cooking there on the skillet. So of course the eggs, the bacon, the cold meats, I'm sure come from outside. But are sauces, are there recipes that you have that?
The last time I counted, we make about 43 different things, right from barbecue sauce to pancake syrup to peanut butter to jam.
So it's made in your home kitchen?
Yeah. And we make a lot of marinades, we do a lot of spice powders.
So there's a flurry of activity here. The restaurant is busy, the kitchen's even busier. So I think we'll leave Nathan to it and we'll head out into the restaurant and check out some of the interesting dishes that makes Hole in the Wall truly unique. Let's go out there. Now, I love the touch of this bookshelf here. This literally feels like, I've entered the library or the study of someone's home. It really feels like somebody's prized book collection. The space here reflects the personality of the owners. It's literally like you've stepped into their home. It's literally like you've stepped into their space. And I think that's a big part of the appeal when it comes to dining at Hole in the Wall Cafe. I will typically visit Hole in the Wall when I feel like eating X for a meal. But today, because we're doing this Gourmet on the Road review, we're going to order a lot more dishes. So I want to do the English breakfast for sure. Then we will also do one skillet egg. What is a skillet egg that you would recommend? Okay, so we'll do one skillet eggs too with the chicken. You know, I want to do one of your burgers. So we'll do the meaty beef cheese burger. We'll do the triple chocolate pancake stack. And we will do the apple waffles too.
So one all English breakfast, one skillet number two chicken pepperoni, one meaty beef cheese burger, bacon and fried egg, and triple chocolate pancake, apple pie waffles, guava juice and cucumber cola.
Yes, I want to do the chicken liver on toast. Thank you. I think I've just shocked the server with my order. I really wanted to try all these dishes. So I have some of my breakfast dishes that have arrived. Of course, this is the beef burger with a fried egg and some bacon in there. The English breakfast. And of course, here I have my skillet eggs. And here I have a dish that I come here. That is my go-to dish at Hole in the Wall, in a manner of speaking. The chicken liver on toast. We're going to start with the English breakfast. Always, always check. Just make sure that it is the pepper. Yes, some pepper on the eggs. And some salt. The service that you have here at Hole in the Wall Cafe is simple. It's non-fussy. It's non-complicated. And I think that also reflects in the plate. So if you look at this plate here, all of the, you know, the eggs, the sausage, the bacon, the mushroom, the baked beans, the tomato, the spinach, and of course the mashed potato is all just assembled on a plate. There's not too much emphasis in terms of presentation. If you want something fancy schmancy, you're in the wrong place. If you want food that's cooked with a lot of care, a lot of love, I think this is the place to be at. So let's go in. Well, for some of the egg first, I think it's nearly 1 o'clock and this is actually my first meal of the day. So it's fitting that I begin my meal with eggs. You know, the egg is just cooked fine. I mean, sometimes the simplest of things take more skill to cook. And I think eggs are definitely one of them. Some bacon to go with that. The bacon has a crunch, but it is not fried to a crisp. I don't like when my bacon is fried to a crisp. I like a bit of the juiciness to still be there in the bacon when I bite into it. Some baked beans. And some chicken sausage that I'm going to bite into now. Very mellow in flavor. Not a big fan of the texture of this chicken sausage. I preferred the bacon more to the sausage. So I'm going to have more of the bacon. Bacon and eggs. Very, very difficult to beat this combination. Some mushrooms. It's a lovely mash. It's not the lightest of mashed potato, but it's definitely feel the weight of the potatoes. It's not too light, but it's seasoned just perfect. Let's try the tomato and the spinach. The last bits of what makes this plate an English breakfast. Perfect. So typically you would come here, order your English breakfast. You have a bit of toast. You have some butter that's served. That's all that you need. But we are here for much more than the English breakfast. So I'm going to move on now to the skillet eggs. I think two eggs, fried, three eggs, I'm not sure. With some chicken pepperoni and some cheese and some chili on top. The forks, the knives, the seasoning, the Tabasco. I think this is the sugar, the napkins right here. You don't need to look around for somebody to help you. Like it would be at somebody's home, no? When you eat at your dinner table, everything is kept right there on the dinner table. You don't have to ask anybody for it. And that's typically the manner in which Hole in the Wall Cafe operates. The pepperoni, I think it's a chicken pepperoni. I'm going to avoid the chili in the first one. And I've got a bit of the cheese. I think this definitely packs in all the goodness of the egg. Didn't have too much of the yellow, so it felt a little bland in terms of its flavor. But this bite, I've got the egg, I've got the yellow, the yolk, I've got the pepperoni, the chicken pepperoni, mind you, and a sliver of the chili. I'm just hoping that the chili isn't too spicy. That was a wonderful, creamy mouthful. I have the creaminess of the yolk, the meaty flavor of the pepperoni, and then I have that punchy heat of the chili. Thankfully, it's not too spicy. So you just have that heat of the chili that hits you at the back of the throat and then just fades away. Tempted me to go for another bite. So I'll have more of the pepperoni as opposed to the egg in this bite. So you got the egg, you got the pepperoni, and you've got the chili hiding somewhere in between. The cheese, you taste it, but you don't taste it as much. So in relation to the flavors of the yolk, the cheese does feel a bit lost. If I were to order this the next time, I would certainly ask them for some extra cheese on my skillet eggs. Delicious. Before I do the burgers, I also have two juices that I've ordered. This is the juice that I typically order every time I come here. And somehow, all year round, they always have fresh guava juice. I don't know how they manage it. And they have this pink guava, which is quite tasty. It's a nourishing juice. It's a sort of juice that will fill you up. You can feel, you can taste the grainy texture of the guava on your palate. And I was also recommended the cucumber and watermelon cooler. I think the watermelon is settled at the bottom, so I'm going to mix this a bit. Nice, light, refreshing. I think I'm going to stick to the guava juice though. That's my favorite here. So let's get back to the burger. A very simple looking burger. So you've got the bun, you've got lettuce, you've got some fried eggs, you've got some tomatoes. And there's the rasher of bacon, and there's some cheese and the tenderloin patty. What I'm hoping will be a juicy, meaty burger. This is going to be messy. There's no dignified way to eat a burger ever, and this one is definitely one of them. I could also taste a bit of a mustard sort of a kick. The meat patty is cooked just right. It still has its juiciness there. Of course, the bacon gives it that savory punch, gives it that savory oomph. And I think the egg, especially with the slightly runny yolk, does well to bring it all together. No French fries, you got potato wafers here. I don't remember the last time I ate potato wafers. It's the sort of burger that you would have if you were invited to a barbecue at your friend's place, and that's really what a burger at Hole in the Wall Cafe is like. It's not one of those hugely layered, pretentious, bacon from some faraway land, exotic vegetables and home-cut fries sort of a burger, but it's a sort of burger that will leave you satisfied and happily so. But I just wish that the bun holding it had a little more strength. It's flavorful, it's tasty. I think the bun, the burger bun, is struggling to contain all of the meat, the egg, the bacon within itself. Other than that, this is a great burger. A burger that will leave you satisfied. You know, there's one dish that I forgot to order, which I have never tasted here before. This is the pizza omelette, or more specifically, the veggie pizza omelette. So this is for vegetarians who like their vegetables and don't want any meat. So then you've got the egg, which functions as the pizza base. You've got some tomato sauce on top. You've got loads of cheese. You've got mushrooms, you've got olives, capsicum, bell pepper, and you've got some chilies as well. I like to eat my pizza with my hand, but I don't think this is one of them. So probably the best way to eat this would be to perhaps roll it up and then take a big eggy mouthful. Here goes. Not bad at all. I was quite skeptical about this dish when I ordered for it as a last minute sort of an addition, but it's quite tasty. So you have the eggs, which gives it that nice base, which gives it body. And then you have the tangy flavors of the tomato, the homemade tomato sauce that's been smeared on the eggs. And then you have that savouriness that comes from the cheese. And of course, the vegetables give it that nice crunch. While eating an entire pizza may be a bit too much, but if you are with a couple of friends, this would make for a nice sharing sort of a dish. Very interesting. Completely surprised by this dish, and pleasantly so. My go-to dish here, which is the chicken liver on toast. So you've got the liver, you've got some onions, you've got some coriander, and maybe some seasoning, and that's just about it. You know, I'm a big fan of chicken liver. I love its intense flavor punch. I think chicken by itself doesn't have as much flavor, let's say, as compared to lamb or mutton. But chicken liver has so much flavor. And I love its soft, almost powdery, yielding sort of a texture. I think I'm going to go with my hands here. I'm going to make a nice mouthful of this chicken liver on toast right here. Can't speak much, but that is so good. That is so good. Definitely, for all you liver lovers out there, a must-eat dish at Hole in the Wall. It's so good. I know I have to stop eating, but I can't help but keep going. This liver is so good. A simple preparation. The onions are halfway to being caramelized, so they're soft, but they have that crunch still. And I think that's what combines so very well with the liver. So good. I think I'm going to keep the savory dishes aside for now and wait for the pancake and the waffle that's coming up next. If this isn't a decadent breakfast, I don't know what is. So I've got my apple pie waffle. So I've got two thick slices of waffle topped with caramelized cinnamon apples, caramel and ice cream, and heaps of caramel all over. And then of course you have the chocolate triple deck pancake. So I think these are chocolate pancakes, drizzled over, slathered over quite generously with chocolate sauce and chocolate shavings on top, which makes it a triple chocolate. So I think I'm going to start with the waffles. You can see that the waffles are nice and gooey inside. I'm going to take a bit of the apple, take a bit of the vanilla ice cream on top, and a bit of the caramel. This is super delicious. The waffles are perfectly cooked. You got the burnt edges, you got the doughy inside, mildly sweet, and then you have the cinnamon apple. If you love something sweet for breakfast, definitely something that should be on your list when you're here. Much as I hate to let go of this, I need to try the triple chocolate pancake. Decadent chocolatey bite. Now, if you like your chocolate, this is chocolate nirvana on a breakfast plate. You can feel the chocolate make its presence felt. You can feel the chocolate ooze into every pore of your palate. The chocolate definitely makes its presence felt. So good. Truth be told, I've never tried any of the dessert breakfasts, if I may call them, here. But having tasted the cinnamon apple pie waffles and the chocolate triple deck pancake, I'm so impressed that I'll definitely come back and order for at least one of these the next time. You know, I've been visiting Hole in the Wall Cafe now for the last 9 or 10 years that they've been around. And each time I visit here, I always leave happy. The food is simple, it's non-pretentious, it's served to you with zero fuss. But it's the sort of food that leaves you happy. It's the sort of food that makes you smile. And I think that's the beautiful thing about Hole in the Wall Cafe. I think Hole in the Wall Cafe is a great story about two individuals who've chosen to come together and serve up some great food. It's simple food, but cooked well, cooked with a lot of love and cooked with care, and served simply so. I think that's what makes Hole in the Wall so popular amongst all Bangaloreans. So if you haven't tried Hole in the Wall Cafe yet, and if you fancy an all-day breakfast, definitely look up Hole in the Wall Cafe at Koramangala in Namma, Bengaluru.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the Support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!